Good morning, all. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your morning flash update for this Thursday, Valentine's Day, 2019 at 9:20 a.m. Central Standard Time. Remember, today at 12:30 p.m. Central Standard Time, we are having our live webinar. So you come in, just make sure your computer speaker's on, type your questions to me, I'll repeat them, answer them. It's about 30, 40 minutes of fun, ideally, but have the questions ready for me. That's what makes this thing work. So in looking at the markets today, a lot of data. You know that we've got the bigwigs, if you will, talking today in China, today and tomorrow, where Mr. Lighthizer and Mnuchin are meeting their counterparts, and we'll see if anything is done. China continues to offer things, but they're in trade. They have not yet, from everything I'm reading, addressed the intellectual property issues. They deny they go on that way. I don't think that's so, and I think you'll find Americans don't believe that. So the market's been all over the board. Look at this move in the gold today. I mean, that's an $11 move already. Silver under a lot of pressure. Copper doesn't know which way to move. Is it going to have bad news or good news come out of these talks? And the problem for metals, the strength in the dollar. Early on, if you were watching Coca-Cola, of all things, the biggest drop in 3 years, down 6%, and as I was reading about it, it appeared to be currency headwinds. Well, if that's Coke, with the dollar pushing these highs of it hasn't seen in years, and the euro got down today to 112.76, other American companies are going to feel the same thing. Energy prices, a little bit of everywhere. Consolidation is the word. The question is, which way does it resolve itself? And on trade and grains, not very good. We're not seeing much movement going on there. I'm also noticing today a pretty big move back into the bonds and notes. I think that's fear. That's why you've got the yen up, even though the dollar is higher today. And I think this is the idea that maybe we're in for disappointment on the U.S. trade. We don't know what the president's going to do with the bill that's going to be supposedly passed today and put to him, and what he's going to do to find that border wall money or for even sign the bill. So there's a lot of unknowns. Economic data wasn't pretty today. PPI came out, final demand down a tenth. They expected it up a tenth. January's producer price index, ex food and energy, up 0.3. They expected up 2, so that's a better number. Consumption, though, down 0.1%. And the December PPI was revised down 0.1 from down 0.2. So I'll call that a mixed report, maybe a little bit to a bounce to it. Advanced retail sales down 1.2%. That is not good. They expected up 0.1%. Ex-autos down 1.8%. They expected up 0.1%. Jobless claims rose 4,000. They were looking for a decline of 9,000. Then you come to the Chinese data, and this was the surprise. Their exports up 9% on the year versus an expected decline of 4.1%. Exports to the U.S. down 2.4% versus December's 3.5% decline. Imports on the year were down at 1.5%. They thought they'd be down more, 11%. And from the U.S., the imports were down, it's not a mistype, 41.2%. The trade surplus with the U.S. did narrow in a little bit because they're not importing from us. You know, that makes sense. Stats Canada today's factory sales falling. Not a pretty sight for them. And in the Eurozone, the economic data came out about where expected. So a big question is, what do these markets do? They're going to hear some things. There's going to always be leaks that you hear about how the trade talks are going, and that's how I'm hearing these things. I'm reading in the different news wires as to what's going on, and I am concerned that while China wants to do more and more trade, they're not addressing the core issue of intellectual property and the coercion of American companies to turn over goods. And of course, they'll say one thing at a national level, and then you got to worry at the local levels, such as subsidies for automobiles. At a national level, they want to do away. But the local regions can continue with it. You know, if you like what I do here, you're going to like what I do in my morning subscriber video. I call this the flash video. In the morning video, my goal is to, you think of me as a buffer. And in that buffer, I'm going to review 40 charts and throw out my trade ideas to you just as the market is live and going on. I cannot do that in these public videos. I can do it when you have a user ID and a password. That's government regulation. So as I do that, I'm assuming you got your cup of coffee. My charts will look just like this, and I'll teach you what's on them. I will review in this exact sequence each and every time so you can move along the bottom as you go with things. I will tell you the chart action. I'm going to tell you what I think the pros are doing. Technical and fundamental information way beyond what you're getting here. And then trade ideas galore. So how do you get to this? Well, it's a subscriber video. And I started off pretty good, 26 cents a day, $7.95 for 30 days. After that, it's either $15 a month or you can buy the whole year at $156, your choice. How do you get to it? Give us a call, 866-973-2077. You can go to our website at www.iraepstein.com. Under the words research, under the words education, morning subscriber video, it'll take you right where you need. I'm Ira. Have a good day. I want to see you at 12:30 p.m. today. Have a great one.